There's a great little tool in Excel called Goal Seek. It's a little bit hidden away, but once you find it and start using it, it's incredibly useful because it takes away all the trial and error that you normally have to do. It allows you to set the final answer and get Excel to work out the best path to get there. So I'm going to explain all of that in this video. Keep watching. Okay, so I'm just going to make up some data here, and I'm going to use a mortgage scenario simply because it has three main variables which are commonly used, which we can use to demonstrate Goal Seek. So first, with a mortgage, we have an amount that we borrow, we have an interest rate that we pay back at, and we have a term, which is normally measured in years, but could be months as well. And obviously, you need some sort of repayment figure. Now, let's make it a monthly repayment, and that's what we're going to calculate. So let's say the amount we're going to borrow is 400,000. Let's say the rate is 5.75%, the term is 30 years, and the monthly repayment is what we're going to calculate. To get an initial repayment figure, I'm going to use the payment function, which is PMT. Open your brackets. Again, if you know your way through the formula, you can just use the guide here, but I'm going to click the FX so it's nice and big and you can see what I'm doing clearly. So first of all, the rate is this figure here, but because we're after a monthly repayment figure, I'm going to divide the annual rate by 12. The NPER is the number of periods or number of payments for your loan, which in this case is 30. But again, that's in years, and I'm after monthly repayments, so I'm going to multiply that by 12 to get the number of payments. The PV is the present value, so how much am I going to borrow? That's the 400,000 here. You'll notice these three are just, they're mandatory. The last two are optional because they're in regular text. But just to explain quickly, the FV is future value. So in the case of a mortgage, hopefully after 30 years you've paid that off and there's no amount outstanding. But let's say you take a shorter loan, like a car loan, you tend to make your payments back over 3 years or 5 years, and then there's a balloon payment or a residual payment at the end. That's what your future value would be in that situation. The type, you can read the description here, says, do you want to pay at the beginning of the month or the end of the month or whatever time period you're using? So I'm going to leave those last two empty just to keep things simple. You'll notice the final result is negative because it's a monthly repayment to a bank, so therefore it's a debt. I'm just going to make this a positive figure. You can either do a negative present value or you can just put a minus in front of the whole payment function. Either way, it kind of switches everything around and your result becomes positive. So let's OK that, and you've got a current monthly repayment figure of this. I'm just going to reduce that down to a whole dollar amount just to keep things simple. That's the setup. Now what we're going to do is to use Goal Seek to change the final monthly repayment figure and see how it affects these three input values. So for example, if you had a pay rise and you could now afford to pay back, I don't know, $2,600 a month, how would it affect how much you could borrow? What could interest rates go up to and you'd still be okay? How much would it reduce your term? So let's go through each of those one at a time. So first of all, we're going to choose the final cell. We go to the data tab. We find the what if analysis tool. And in there is one called Goal Seek. This is the tool, so it's not many things to set. And what you basically do is to set the final answer to whatever you want it to be and then get Excel to work backwards for you. And it removes all the trial and error for you. So we set this value to 2,600. That's what we decided. By changing, and here you can change any one of these three input cells, which of course all affect this. So we're going to start with the amount. Click OK, and it works it out, and it tells you you can now afford to borrow 445,000, so you've got 45,000 extra to play with. Let's do another example. So again, what if analysis, Goal Seek. I'm going to set B4 to 2,600 again, keep it consistent, by changing the rate. So let's click OK there. And it says you could actually go up to 6.77%. So it gives you 1 and a bit percentage points to play with in terms of interest rate rises. One last example. Let's again set the final value to 2,600 by changing the term. And what this tells you is that by paying a little bit extra, it's about $250 extra, you're reducing your term by nearly 7 years. And it just goes to show you that if you pay a little bit extra early, you can actually take quite a bit off the number of years you're paying back your loan because of compound interest. You know, you pay off your interest early. That's not compounding then through the life of your loan. That's an example of Goal Seek. You do your basic formula. You then get Excel to work backwards, but fix the answer first. And Excel works backwards to change the input, whichever one you say.